Let's study the force between the plates of a parallel plate capacitor. We know that whenever a parallel plate capacitor is charged by using a potential difference, the two plates of capacitor will receive equal and opposite charges. This we already discussed in the amount of charge on capacitor plate in final stage. We write as CV. One plate carries a charge plus Q, other carries a charge minus Q. As obviously the two plates carry opposite charges, they'll attract each other with some attractive force F. Obviously here we cannot apply Coulomb's law because these are not point charges, these are distributed. In this situation, there exists some electric field between the plates of capacitor. And we can directly write the net electric field between capacitor plates is, this E can be written as V by D if V is the potential difference across the plates, or if we are given with the surface area of plate as A, the surface charge density on the plate sigma can be written as Q by A, and between the plates electric field can be written as sigma by epsilon naught, which can also be written as Q by A epsilon naught. All the three relations are valid for calculation of electric field between the plates of capacitor. But if we calculate the electric field between plates only due to one plate, or here only due to plate X, then we know that only due to one plate, electric field between the plates will be sigma by 2 epsilon naught, and it is due to both of these plates, it is sigma by epsilon naught. So we can write that electric field only due to plate X in the region is equals to half of this, which is Q by twice of A epsilon. Now, if we wish to calculate the force on plate Y, it must be due to the electric field by the plate X. Now you can easily understand why I have calculated the electric field only due to plate X. Because in the net electric field, contribution of plate X as well as Y exists. And if I wish to calculate the force on plate Y, its own electric field can never exert a force on itself. But now I can calculate that attractive force on plate Y is, this force I can write as the charge on plate Y in magnitude is Q multiplied by the electric field due to the plate X. So if I substitute the value of this electric field, you can see I'm getting the force acting on the plate Y due to plate X. That will be Q square by 2A epsilon naught. And the same amount of force will be exerted by plate Y on plate X according to Newton's third law. So this itself is a very good and useful relation to be used in various numerical problems. The force between the plates of a parallel plate capacitor is Q square by 2 epsilon naught.